Hello friends, today I'm going to show you how you can use Markov chains to write a program which can predict a next word which should be typed by user and auto suggest to him. You might have seen these in Swift keyboards in your mobiles. When you type something, you are all suggested by the next keyword. How it is done? They create a database, whatever you type, and it is stored, and then it is suggested to the user. Here, this program will run on command prompt that I'm going to run Python, and then your program name. You will type something, and it will suggest you, as soon as you type space, it will suggest you what should be the next word. You can press tab if you like the word that has been suggested. For example, here I liked I, then it suggested like. I typed like, then it suggested ML or reading. They are the two possible words which user has typed in his experience. So I typed ML now. So it suggested that it should be books. I can type something else as well, but now these are the positive cases. So I took all the positive cases that this program has suggested to me. Let us take another positive test case. Let us say I. And then it suggested like. I typed ML read. Typed like. It suggested like ML or reading. I chose reading now. Then it suggested books or ML. I took ML, and then it is out of suggestions now because it has typed an end. Let us take some negative test cases. I'll say I. Like, I do not say like, I'll say love, though it is out of suggestions now. Why it is out of suggestion, that I'm going to explain now. So let us take some other words. Say reading, I love reading, but it is still out of suggestions. Now take another negative test case. I like ML reading, what should we take? Let's say flowers. So it is out of suggestions again because their flower is not into the database. Why it is happening? I'll show you the database which is there. So this file is the database which it has learnt. It has three sentences. I like. One second. So you can see. First word is taken as I, and after that is always like. As it is always like, that is why it always suggested like. There is no other possibility in its database. Then the next word after like, there were two possible options, ML or reading into this file in the first two sentences. So it suggested either ML or reading. If I take ML, it suggested books. If I take reading, it again suggested books. So books is the last after both of these. So this is how it learned. I'll take you through the code in detail how it is happening. So I hope you are clear by now how it is being correlated on the console command prompt, as well as into its database. I can add one more sentence to increase the database and see how it behaves. So first let me explain the code. This train data is the code which from the file name train_text.txt, right? Which it reads. Then I created three dictionaries. One is first possible words, which is the first word of the sentences. Then second possible word, because we are suggesting the based on first and second words. So these are the values which are held by these dictionaries. And third one is the transition, which contains all the possible transitions from one state to another state. Here is the transition dictionary. As you can see, let us go by one first. So first one, you see do and I are the two possible values in first one, because in the three sentences only two possible characters are words are there, either I or do. But as I has repeated twice, so its probability is 66%. Though we are not going to use the first word probability, we are going to use other words probability. Now let us take the second word probability. If after I, it is always like, so it is only one word here, like. If it is do, then there is only one word you, which is in the third sentence that you can see. So it is the probability of this you after do is 1. 1 means 100%. Let us add one more sentence. Do I what can we add? Let's add, do I like flowers? Yep. So let us run the code again. We'll put a breakpoint and then run it again so that variables can populate it. Now let us see the first and second. We'll see the second one itself. Second one now has changed you as and I. As you can see, after do, there are two possible combinations in sentence 3 and sentence 4. Either it is you or it is I. As there are two, probability will divide 50-50 between the two. And stop the code and test it. We'll type do. Then it says either it is you or it is I. Right. Then if I type you, then it's suggested that you like flowers and all that kind of stuff. Right. Like reading. Why it suggested reading after like, though it was not in sentence? Because this you like, it took first two last two words, and after that the possible combination was there in was reading. That's how it works. It is there in transition. Let's see the transition dictionary. Where is you and like combo? Yeah, it is a you like combo. After that, you can see only reading possibility is there, which 100% probability. If so, if user are typing do you or XYZ you like, then it is possible that they are going to type the reading that has been suggested by the program. Now let us go through the code. As I suggested, there are three dictionaries. You can see how you can take a glimpse of the on the dictionary data. For I like, you can see there are three words. How the probability is divided? If there suppose in all the sentences ML is coming multiple times, then same way the probability gets divided 6/2 and all. Let's go through the code. There are three functions. One is train Markov model, then which internally uses expand dictionary or the get next probability. What they do is they fill in the first three dictionaries, and next word is the function which I've created to get the next word probability. Here I'm going to pass a tuple or a word. If it is a plain word, I assume that it's the first word of the sentence, so it will search for the first word dictionary. Otherwise it is going to use the other one. The highlighted code that you have seen is only the client code. You can replace this code, it's a black screen code in this demo. You can replace it with your JavaScript or chatbot code or whatever, which is going to suggest something to the user. Right here in this, you can see I'm using MS VCRT to get individual character by character by the user and printing it. If user types carriage return, I mean enter, then just close the code and close the input. If it presses tab, then accept it and don't print anything except the suggestion that has been given last, right? And if you can see here, I'm using c.decode because it's a binary character. And if it is a space, then convert it to a string, append to the sentence, and check, and then split the sentence to get the word tokens. Now these tokens are used individually, word by word, one after the another, to search within the dictionary, and wherein this next word function is called. So here I have used it. This algorithm is based on last two words which have been searched, right? In your practical scenarios, you can actually use multiple level of probability matrices. And here the only two words are enough to give the user a suggestion of what should be there, right? Okay, let's see the other piece of code. Train Markov model. What it does is it reads line by line your file, the database that you have given to it. You can then splits it into the string and then finds out whether it's the first character, second character, or the remaining characters. If it is the first character, then it adds it to the first possible word dictionary, line number 28. And if it is second, then it goes to the other one, line number 31, and uses expand dictionary function to create a dictionary where the second word has been added to the second possible words dictionary. Then you can see what it does is it simply adds a tuple to this second dictionary. And you can see here, suppose if do comes, then it says you and this one, you and whatever it was, to the dictionary with the probability. And for the remaining ones, it just goes to going to add the transitions. These three dictionaries are actually the core data that has been generated by this train Markov model. You know, machine learning is all about data and putting that into right structure into the matrix. Yes, this one we were talking about previously as well. The get next probability, what it does is, suppose your ML reading and flowers is coming multiple times into your database. So it calculates the total number of words, and then this get next probability function is doing this stuff. If ML is coming six, assume three times out of six, then its probability will become 3/6, 50%. Suppose reading comes two times, then it will become 2/6. So it will go for some 2/6, whatever it is. And suppose flower comes 1/6, so probability will become like that. So it's the same way it is being calculated by this function and updated into this data structure, into these dictionaries, right? This is how the code is. I put the code on GitHub. You can go through it, tweak it, and use it. Give me your comments if you like it. Subscribe. Thanks.